Hello and welcome to the episode 195 of What a Fab Day. I am your host, Simon Mas. Today, we'll see the Beatles playing a double feature at the Cavern Club for the first time, playing in Wales for the first time, and appearing on the first ever Top Gear BBC radio show. On the 14th of July 1961, the Beatles, with Pete Best on drums, performed for the first time in the same day a lunchtime and an evening concert at the Cavern Club in Liverpool. It was the first of several of these occasions in the next 2 years. For the evening performance, the band was supported by the White Eagle Jazz Band and Ian and the Zodiacs. In 1962, the same lineup of the Beatles performed for the first time in Wales, at the Regent Dance Set in Rhyl. The ballroom was really a billiard club, situated above a branch of the Barton's Tailoring local franchise. The stage was built with wooden planks laid over the billiard tables. Sharing the stage, quote-unquote, with a local group, the Strangers, the Beatles received £4, about £87 in 2020 money, for their appearance. 1 year later, in 1963, the Beatles performed at the ABC Theatre in Blackpool. On the 14th of July 1964, the Beatles were at the Broadcasting House Studios in London. Between 6:15 and 7 p.m, Paul McCartney recorded a solo interview with Michael Smee, clocking about 13 minutes. The interview was aired by the BBC General Overseas Services on two occasions. The first, featuring an edited version of the interview lasting just 5 minutes, was broadcast on the 18th of July between 11:15 p.m. and midnight during the Highlight program. The second, lasting 11 minutes, was broadcast as A Beatles Eye View on the 22nd of December between 7:30 and 7:45 a.m. After the interview, the whole band reconvened in Studio S2 to record their appearance on the first ever Top Gear show. Born out of the necessity to keep the pace with the transformation of pop music from teenage entertainment into young adults' artistic playground, Top Gear was meant to become BBC Radio 1's flagship program for, quote-unquote, progressive music, until its demise in September 1975. It has then nothing to do with a modern BBC TV show focused on cars. The Beatles taped their performance of Long Tall Sally, Things We Said Today, A Hard Day's Night, and I Love Her, If I Fell, and You Can't Do That. A Hard Day's Night featured the original EMI recording for the middle eight, because the band couldn't play it correctly, due to the absence of producer George Martin, who had played the piano solo in the studio recording. Another studio recording included in the program was I Should Have Known Better. The Beatles also recorded the usual chatting and bantering with Top Gear host Brian Matthew. After that, George, Paul, and Ringo went on to record spoken trailers for the program, showing their appreciation for the new series and for producer Bernie Andrews, a friend of the band. Top Gear debuted on air with the Beatles material recorded today on the 16th of July from 10 to 11:55 p.m. And with this, we have concluded today's episode, short and sweet. Before we go, please remember to share this episode on your social media or with your friends with some good old word of mouth. Increasing the size of the audience will mean building a bigger community of people that are interested about rock music history, and it benefits everyone, fans, creators, and musicians alike. Thank you, and see you tomorrow. For the moment, I wish you a good day and a fab continuation. Simon Mas, music you love.